Is actually quite a high. Season Fiorentina reaching the final. In fact, last year there was an Italian team this cadet was brought to an end in 2020 after 9 titles in a row, and since then Serie A has had a different champion each season, with Inter, AC Milan and Napoli all winning the league. Along with that, the top 4 places are very competitive. For the last 8 seasons, the top 4 teams have changed every season, with the likes of Atalanta, Lazio and Napoli all breaking into the top 4. It's definitely a very, very competitive league nowadays, with about 8 really good teams. And the only reason it's not a 10 is because I can't really ignore the 9 in a row done by Juventus, so just a minus point for that. Talent development is a 5 out of 10. Now this one's interesting, because in terms of young player development, it's a 1 out of 10, because Serie A in recent years has really not developed many youngsters. And this is a big problem and a reason why the Italian national team is currently suffering, because players have begun to get old and not been able to get replaced because there's no one there to replace them. So yeah, there's not really many youngsters in Serie A being developed, but in terms of developing older players, it's a 10. The amount of older players who join Serie A after being outcasted in other leagues and then turn into stars is insane. If you have a look at the Italian national team, as I said, basically all of them played in Serie A, the Euro-winning team. And then you've got players like Dzeko, Giroud, Damian, Mkhitaryan, Pedro, even Lukaku, who have all revived their careers in Serie A and developed as players. So I think that really balances out to an average score of 5 there, 5 out of 10. Global popularity is a 3 out of 10, however. So Serie A's overseas TV rights are pretty minimal compared to other leagues, only just marginally above Liga, and suggesting that Serie A isn't very popular globally. Now, you obviously have some big clubs like AC Milan and Juventus who attract a decent number of global fans, but I think on a global aspect, Serie A isn't really the league. Their broadcasting packages and revenues are better than Liga, but not really competing with the other leagues, so I'll give it a 3 out of 10. Right, let's move on to La Liga then. So star power for La Liga is an 8 out of 10. Now a few years ago this would be like a 1000 out of 10, when Ronaldo, Messi, Bale, Neymar, all of these guys were there. Star power was what La Liga was built on. Nowadays it's diminished, but recently it has grown again. The acquisition of Jude Bellingham is big for this, and same with players like Lewandowski, Vinicius Jr., all major stars. But I think the main star power, to be honest, is Real Madrid and Barcelona. These clubs are the star power of the league, as they are just such huge clubs. And while La Liga doesn't quite have those large names anymore, it's still got a few big ones, and I think the name of Real Madrid and Barcelona alone is enough star power in my opinion, so that's an 8 out of 10. Continental success is a 9 out of 10. This is where La Liga really comes to life. La Liga has dominated European competitions. So if we look at the last 5 years, La Liga has 6 European trophies. Now these mainly come from Madrid and Sevilla, with Atletico and Villarreal picking up a Europa League, but still their dominance is insane. And this period doesn't even include the Madrid and Sevilla freebie. The only reason it's not a 10 is because it's mainly only Madrid and Sevilla who pick up the trophies, and the likes of Barcelona and Atletico Madrid in the last 5 years have been pretty abysmal in Europe and the Champions League especially. But having said that, it still gets a 9 out of 10. Let's move on to competitiveness now, and it's a 3 out of 10. It's a familiar story with La Liga every year since the 2003-04 season. Real Madrid and Barcelona have won all but 2 league titles, and the top 3 finishers have been the same in the last 10 seasons. So it's really dominated by Real Madrid and Barca, with Atletico Madrid just behind. But that being said, it's not always winning. They've picked up a couple here with Frankfurt and Bayern Munich. So it's a solid 6. Competitiveness is a 2 out of 10. I mean, 11 in a row kind of speaks for itself. City win the Champions League, but no other English team in the Champions League still better. Fast Boys an 8 out of 10. I think it has to be lower than La Liga, just because La Liga do get all the trophies, but it's still fantastic. I mean, 8 out of 10. Competitiveness, they say 6 out of 10. Now, this is actually kind of similar to Liga. Say some of the academies of the big clubs are really good. You know, Chelsea produced the likes of Reece James, Mason Mount, Phil Foden, Man City, Marcus Rashford, Man United, Arsenal, Bukayo Saka. So definitely good at developing talent through the academies. It's just fairly average, you know. It's players gone to the Prem, I think, always at a decent level. Seventh place with 34 can see it's pretty close in terms of my criteria and the point system. Bundesliga 25, Liga 26, Serie A 28, La Liga, there's a little bit of a jump there between La Liga and Prem and the rest of them. La Liga with 34 and Prem with 35. To be fair, that's probably not the ranking I would have had going into this. Personally, I probably would have had Liga last, Bundesliga, then La Liga, then Serie A, then Prem. But that just shows that I was trying to be as unbiased as possible. I know a lot of you would probably disagree with quite a few of the rankings I put, and that's fair, so just let me know in the comments below if I should have, if I was too harsh on one or too lenient on one of them, because that will change the scores quite a bit.